Today is the ultimate showdown. Who can make the best grilled cheese sandwich?
Grilled cheese.
I've taken the liberty to challenge Jessie's voice actor, aka my girlfriend, beautiful Hollow Angel. Go subscribe to her, by the way. She's very creative. Aww. To a grilled cheese showdown.
Oh, yeah.
See all that? It's the beautiful sight of Texas. Oh, and no, I don't live here.
Typically, when you think of a grilled cheese sandwich, you think of bread and your assorted Kraft singles. But what if we were to spice it up a bit by doing the bread, a variety of cheeses, yes, the cream cheese, that's all heard on me, and butter or mayo, which if you use butter, you're doing it right. If you're using mayo, then you know what? Good for you. For her, she's using the pickles.
Yep.
What are you thinking right now?
I'm thinking geniusly.
Geniusly.
First off, I'm gonna start by mixing my cheese mixture. So I'm gonna get my cream cheese and I'm gonna mix it with the cheeses that I'm gonna use.
Okay.
Let me get some stuff to open this.
Alright. Oh, let's not get demonetized for this.
It's cooking. It's a cooking thing. We won't get demonetized, right?
No, we won't get demonetized.
Unless we cook another person.
That's supposed to be the next episode.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Oops, I spoiled it.
Oh, shit, the body's getting out.
No.
It's okay, he didn't escape.
Okay, good.
That'll be for the next episode, which we'll post on Patreon, okay? So, let's go over what we have in the way of cheeses. Obviously, we're not using Kraft singles. We're using a variety of different cheeses. All great value brand, by the way. So we have a Colby Jack, a Taco Blend, Italian, and a Mozzarella for that extra stringiness, you know?
Oh, yeah.
This is a public service announcement to Gordon Ramsay. It's not that hard. If you're gonna make a grilled cheese, make a grilled cheese. A grilled cheese should be comforting. It shouldn't involve using kimchi.
And shortbread.
And fancy cheeses.
And short rib, I meant to say. Not shortbread.
I love shortbread.
I love myself some shortbread, too.
I'm talking about shortbread.
You're a shortbread. So she's got that half stick of cream cheese going in right now.
Yep. I'm having trouble with it. All right. That's fine. I only need this half.
I can already tell people in the comments are going to blow up on you for using cream cheese.
Cream cheese is like one of the most delicious ingredients ever. You can make it in desserts, you can make it in casseroles, you can make all kinds of stuff.
Can you explain to people, like, where do you think people in the right mind would use cream cheese?
It's creamy, it's savory, it mixes well with other flavors, it absorbs all of the good flavor.
Okay.
And especially with the pickles, it'll absorb some of that flavor to it, and it'll spread throughout the sandwich.
Apparently, cream cheese is our savior. And what kind of cheese choices are we using?
I'm going with mozzarella and Italian style.
Okay, then I guess I'm stuck with the taco and Colby Jack.
Alrighty.
But I'm gonna steal the mozzarella too. See you later. I gotta do this. I just have to do it. Hey.
What are you doing?
You gotta pay the cheese tax.
The cheese tax. That's onion powder, some fajita seasoning, some salt. Can you smell this?
Baby!
What's wrong?
Let me open it. I can't open it.
Alright. Wait, hold on, wait. Hold on. Okay, there we go.
Thank you.
So unfortunately, we're in Texas, and we were hoping we can get our hands on some of that big, thick Texas toast bread, but unfortunately, we couldn't find it. So we got the large, which, you know, I mean, eh. You see her mixture right here. It's looking kind of interesting.
Don't worry, I'm gonna put it in the microwave.
Oh, well, I figured you'd serve it up cold.
I need to warm up the cream cheese so I can mix it all together.
You put some salt in it, which, aren't you concerned about that a little bit? Because the cream cheese has enough salt.
I'm good. I like salt.
Okay, if you say so.
We're not going for health here. We're going for flavor and tasty, good grilled cheeseness. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we can actually mix it up. Need a fork.
It's a fork.
A butter knife will do.
When you don't feel like doing dishes, when in doubt, choose what you got. So I'm kind of intrigued by what you got so far.
Creamy, cheesy goodness is what I get.
Oh, by the way, loser has to do the dishes tonight.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
I'm gonna cry.
This little mixture here, she's also adding fajita seasoning, I think.
Ooh, yeah, I already added it.
Okay.
So I'm gonna use mayo along with some spices to make sure the bread is nice and flavorful. And also to like, so you can add flavor to both the inside and the outside of the sandwich.
Yep.
I'm also gonna be using butter just to make sure it doesn't stick to the pan and stuff like that.
That's what good pussy sounds like.
It's just family friendly.
You think this channel is family friendly?
You make cartoons.
I make cartoons. Is Family Guy family friendly?
No.
No. Is South Park family friendly? No.
What is your audience? What kind of people comment on your videos?
Kids and teenagers.
Kids.
But that doesn't mean they should be.
That's true, but they are the majority.
Okay. What are you adding now?
Steak seasoning. I'm a Texan. I have a lot of flavor in my food.
Well, too much flavor.
Too much.
Grilled cheese expert judge today.
You're the judge today who's going to be testing this. The loser has to wash the dishes. Born in Texas, baked in Texas since 1908. So, you dry out the pickles. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't it just been easier to use a cucumber?
No. The cucumbers don't taste like pickles until they're pickled.
Okay, I didn't know you were the queen of the pickles.
The queen? I never said I was. I was just stating some basic facts.
And now the basic facts with Jesse's voice actor. Give us the fact of the day.
Pickles are tasty as heck.
This is concluded. Jesse's voice actor's facts.
Even dry enough to where they aren't drenching the sandwich in pickle juice.
Okay, so you're patting them dry.
Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna use all of it.
Holy crap.
Just wait till it's melted. It'll look a lot better when it's melted.
And now a quick word from our sponsor. If you're ever feeling tired, are you feeling down? Are you feeling thirsty? Well, drink some water then. This video is sponsored by water.
Water.
Drink it, you simpleton.
For here, she puts the pickles on slowly, one at a time. Oh yes, beautiful.
Beautiful.
Right, well, we'll turn back to that once it's toasted then. So while you are over there making your cream cheese concoction, I'm doing it old school style and using Taco Blend and Colby Jack, because you know what? We like to be different here.
You don't tell me what you're putting in your sandwich!
You shouldn't be listening!
Where else am I supposed to go?
I don't know! Go take a walk! Yeah, these are the cheeses that we are using today. And after that, we're gonna do a thing.
What thing are we doing?
I haven't thought about it yet, okay? I'm not good on camera. All I know for a fact is that we are going to stick to the classic, okay? This is a two cheese special.
All right.
So how do you make the perfect grilled cheese? Well, first you need a table.
First you need a table.
Two slices of bread, obviously. We're gonna go for just the classics here, okay? We're not gonna do any of these little pickles, you know? We're not gonna go for any of this special concoction here. We are doing bread, cheese,
and country crock butter.
But what our judge doesn't actually know is that this isn't a two cheese special. It's gonna be a three cheese special.
Ooh.
Gotta get that stringiness.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta be able to beat out the competition. I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what.
You think I would go half-half, and you're kind of right on that. I would go probably about a little bit of some Colby on the bottom. A little bit, sprinkle up some our special cheese.
Mozzarella.
Some mozzarella. We don't want to make it too thick, you know?
Mm.
We have taco blend, which is a mix of certain kind of cheeses. You got taco seasoning in it.
What? White people will butter the bread. Mm-hmm. But I kind of like what your plan is because you're still toasting it and everything and it's still melting. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to stick with that for now and we're going to keep it simple. Though I will say...
I need to take it off. It's ready.
So she just finished up her sandwich, and now I'm going to start on mine and put some butter in the pan.
Look at that. Sizzle.
Ah!
Sizzle! Don't butter. Hurt yourself.
It's butter rebellion!
It's hot butter. Butter in the south.
We'll be right back with a toasted grilled cheese sandwich for taste testing.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So while we're in the process of waiting for my sandwich to finish up, let's see how this looks. Ooh. Better than the last one.
Are we ready to see what the judge sees of this one?
I think so, but let's wait until mine's done.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, sandwiches.
Excellent burnage. Not too bad. Yes. Yes. I have a feeling I know whose is his. But it smells good. Crunch. There's butter. I'm sorry, Liam. They're both delicious, I swear, but like, I'm just into pickles. And like, all the flavors together.
You know what? I take it as a learning experience.
No, but this is really good too. It really is. The butter and the toastage and the melty cheese.
Okay. Well, at least I did something right. All right. It looks like I'm going to have to be the one to do the dishes today. You want to make me one of those sandwiches so I could try?
Sure.
Wonderful.